someone's here, thankfully, and so we will now continue with the case and Mr. Thompson.
The defense next calls Mark Saunders. Good morning again, Mr. Saunders. You are the brother of Steven, correct?
Yes.
The older brother, younger brother?
I'm 2 years older.
Okay. Now, what area do you live in generally? Where do you live?
Philadelphia.
Okay. Now, where do you work?
I'm retired police officer.
Retired police officer? From what department?
Camden.
Camden? Retired, you have a pension from the police department?
Every month.
Okay. Now, I want to draw your attention to a point in time back in 2017. And I'll ask you, whether you learned that your brother Stephen had been arrested back in November 2017.
Yes.
Now, some time just prior to that, had you met Steven for something? Did you meet up with Steven? Let me stop. What day of the week did you understand that he and Steven had gotten arrested?
Monday.
Okay. Did you meet with him on Monday?
Monday afternoon, but prior I saw him Saturday.
Okay. So before he got arrested, you had seen him Saturday, was the last time you had seen him?
Yes.
Where were you when you saw him?
I have a rental property on the corner of Broadway Empire. Steven lives on Empire.
Okay.
So he has to pass my rental property to get to his house.
Okay. Now, where were you when you saw him that Saturday?
I was standing outside of my phone while the guy was inside my house fixing heat.
Okay. And Steven came by, rode by?
Rode by.
Okay. And did he get out of his car?
Yes.
And what were you doing specifically?
Standing on the side, just on the phone.
Did you and he have some kind of conversation?
Yes.
What was the nature of the conversation?
He wanted to borrow some money to go on a trip that I had no idea about.
Did you understand that he was going on a trip alone?
No, he was going on a trip with my two other brothers, but I wasn't asked to go.
Sounds like you're a little bothered by that.
A little bit.
So, you didn't invite you on a trip, but you wanted to borrow money from you.
For that trip, yeah.
Okay. Did you agree to loan him some money?
After a couple of words, yeah.
Okay. How much money did he ask you for? Or did he ask for an amount?
He said anything over $1,000 to help. Anything with the help. So what I did was, I gave him $1,200 for $1,000. That's how I looked at it.
Did you write him a check or give him cash? What did you do?
I gave cash.
You had that kind of cash on you?
All the time. I have rental properties. And the rental properties, I don't take checks for my rental properties. Because sometimes checks are bounced.
I understand.
And I don't take money orders because I had one person give the money order, then he went down there and canceled that money order.
Okay.
So I don't take cash only. And then also what I do is that I get a retirement check from the police department. I get one from the military. I drive Uber sometimes. I just stay busy. And I'm in school. And I get money. Military give me a stipend for going to school.
So it's not unusual that you might have some cash in your pocket?
I get it.
You have cash in your pocket now? Now, apparently, Steven was aware that you had the money. And so you loaned him money. Do you recall the denominations of the money you loaned him?
Hundreds, a couple of hundreds, 50s, and not a whole lot of 20s. Because 20s sticks out and look like you got money. I don't like that.
Okay. So how long were you talking with him before you agreed to give him money? Did you withdraw that? Did you take money right out of your pocket then and just hand it to him?
No.
How did it work? How did that work out?
I told him I mean it because I had to finish with the guy with the heater. I didn't know how much money that was going to cost me.
Okay.
Because I wasn't working on the heater, and if I need parts or not, I didn't know. So I didn't want to stop what I was doing to go get the money. Mm-hmm. So I told Steven I'd just meet him later. And so I said, I'm just about after 8 o'clock.
Okay.
So that's what I did. I mean, 8 o'clock until his house at 8 o'clock.
You went to his house?
I went to his house at 8 o'clock. It's right down the street from my home.
Okay. Right. Now, Steven's your brother.
Yes.
Okay. You guys get along pretty well. Sometime. Most of the time.
It's we're brothers.
Okay.
What it is that it's 8 of us total.
Okay.
I have brothers? 5 brothers. I have 5 brothers, 2 sisters. I received my mom and dad passed, and I received the rental property. I received that.
Okay.
None of my brothers received it but me. So it's still a little animosity there.
Okay. There's 2 gentlemen in the back of the courtroom, your brothers too, right?
Right. They went on a trip, and I didn't go. Everybody went with me.
Okay. Okay. Now, you are Stephen's brother, so I guess it sort of begs the question of whether you would come in here and testify for something just to help Steve out and testify falsely. Would you do such a thing?
I get a pension every month.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going to mess up.
What do you mean by that?
You can't do it in a criminal. You get a pension fund in the police department, you can't do it in a criminal.
Okay.
So I don't mess that up.
Okay.
I get that for life.
Okay. So have you ever been, of course you've never been, well, let me withdraw. Have you ever been convicted of a crime?
No.
Have you ever been charged with a crime?
Yes.
Never convicted of any crime?
No.
Okay. That's all I have, Your
Honor. Is the gentleman
Mr. Saunders, first I just want to clarify. Well, first I'll ask you, you're retired. Why did you retire? Just out of curiosity.
I was involved in a police shooting in Canada.
And
the suspect died. And since the suspect died, the trauma actually allowed me to leave.
Right, because you couldn't, because the trauma couldn't be a police officer anymore, is what
right.
You're saying? And since you retired, you keep busy doing other stuff, you testify to a few sources of income, like rental properties and other things. All right, so are you frequently giving money to your brothers and your siblings?
I gave him some money. I gave my sister, she's having problems with her family divorce, I gave her money.
Is it normal for your brother to come and just ask for money to go on a vacation?
No.
And you still gave it to him?
Sure. He needed money for help with some bills on the house. I paid that. I paid his mortgage. Can I talk to him?
Well, I just asked you if you gave him money to go on a vacation.
I was trying to tell you what I gave money for.
Well, the question was about the vacation, not anything else.
Okay.
But if you ask me about anything else, you certainly would be able to talk about it.
So you said that he asked you for money so he could have fun on a vacation, and that's even a vacation that you were not invited on, and you still gave him $1,200?
Yes.
And you seem to remember this really well, but this was approximately 2 years ago?
17.
Yeah. Did you, like, write this all down so you could refresh your memory, or you just remember this well? Like, all the details about the air conditioner, what you were doing that day and all that information. This is all just from your memory?
I remember it only because it was going on a trip that I wasn't invited to.
So that detail you really remember?
I remember that quite well.
But somehow you're also able to remember that you were at the rental property because the air conditioner was getting fixed?
Heater.
You remember very well. And you said he came on Saturday?
Morning.
Saturday morning, so your brother comes over. How do you know you were there? Just Do you know how you were there?
I'm standing outside. I live on the corner house. So I'm on Wildwood's this way, Empire's this way. The back door is on Empire. So I'm standing right by the back door.
You didn't live at that house though, did you?
It's from
right. Right. So you're out front and you think he still saw you?
I'm out on the side.
The side, but where you could see from the road?
Yes.
Okay. And so he pulls up Saturday morning and he says he wants money to go on a vacation. And she said, well, I got to deal with this stuff at their own property. Is that pretty much how
it wasn't. It wasn't like that. We started talking. Then he said about going on a trip. Then we started talking about the trip. That's when I found out that it's a trip that I wasn't right.
Okay. And you said that you weren't real happy about that?
No, right? Yeah. Then we started arguing some more about that. And then we had money, and that's actually how much.
Right, and then later on, you did get the money.
Right.
How'd you get the money again?
Went home.
So you went back to your house, and you live in Philadelphia?
Yes.
What was going on with the rental property when you left?
He was fixed.
So the heater guy, was it already done? You waited until it was done?
He just had to recalibrate something, check something, and he did something with it. I know it cost him like $120.
Right.
So okay. Once I paid him, I rode around this up before, then I didn't come back to Steve around like after 8.
And you paid him just out of cash in pocket, the heater guy?
Yes.
Okay. So you go back to Philadelphia?
Yes.
And then you go back to the rental property or you go to your brother's house?
Brother's.
And then you just had you don't need to say where you live or anything, but you keep cash in your house that's available to you?
Sometimes.
You did this time, though? You had
yeah,
cash
I keep it there. Sometimes all depends on what day of the week. Because rental properties, I collect the money. Sometimes I collect the money on the first, sometimes I collect on the fifth, sometimes I collect on the seventh. So if you collect in one of those days, it might be on me, or it might be my car. I don't know.
But this time it was in your house?
This is my house.
So then you went back and you gave the money to $1,200 you gave it to your brother that same day?
Yes.
But at nighttime?
At nighttime.
And again, this was Saturday?
Yes.
All Saturday. When did you learn that your brother had been arrested?
Monday.
So you found out that he was arrested on Monday. Do you know that he was arrested on Monday?
No, my other brother back there told me that Stephen got arrested.
So on Monday, one of your brothers back there says, Mark, Stephen got arrested. Did you talk to your brother, Steven, that day? Or when did you talk to him about it?
I talked to him that day.
And, before he got arrested, after he got arrested?
After he got arrested, when he came back home.
So was that actually, the morning of the next day?
I couldn't tell you. I know it was an afternoon because he was over there, and I went over there, and that was another one.
And what did you argue with him about?
Because I was going to make up for $1,200.
What did he say about it?
He said that they took the money. So how did he get the money?
And did you know that when he was arrested, that he gave an interview or a statement that lasted about 2 hours?
No, I didn't know that.
And would it surprise you to hear that in that 2-hour interview, he did not mention anything one time? Would it surprise you to hear that in that 2-hour interview, when they asked how he got the money, he did not? Your brother did not mention your name one time?
I didn't tell you, I don't know.
You don't know?
How would you ask me?
I'm asking you, is it surprising to hear that your brother was asked many times where he got the money and he never said one time that you gave him money?
It didn't surprise
me. It doesn't surprise you? Why? Because your brother doesn't usually tell people what really happened? Is that why it doesn't surprise you?
Well, it's kind of hard to try to explain who you got money from and, who you got it from.
Well, would it surprise you to hear that he did explain that he got money from other people?
Okay.
Okay. It does surprise you?
I don't know. I'm just trying to figure out that if he didn't say it, that's fine. I'm just saying that I know what I gave him.
Okay. And you talked to him after he got arrested, right?
Yes.
And you don't really know what day it was, or do you know what day it was?
It's Monday.
Was it the same day that he got arrested?
I don't know. The only thing I know is my brother, Jeffrey, called me and told me. And that's when I arrived. That's how a couple hours later.
On Monday?
It was Monday, yes.
And since you talked to him that Monday, have you talked to him about this since, him being arrested?
Like we just talked general about the charge and stuff like that, like different things or stuff like that, but not like concrete.
Right, you talked about the charges and some of the charges involved him getting money, didn't you?
Yeah, I asked him where I got my money back.
Well, you also talked after that about part of the charges against him have to do with the money that he had on his person, didn't you?
Yes.
So you know that is a big part of what he's charged with, how he got that money.
Right, and that's why I asked him, shouldn't I get my money back?
Right, and did you talk to him before the trial, like in the days before the trial?
Well, he said that he's going to have to, he wanted me to go testify, he's had enough for you, and he was already afraid because I was already mad.
And he wanted you to say that you gave him money, right?
No, he wanted me to say what you did. And he was afraid that he knew what I was going to say. I was pissed off that I gave him money that I wasn't invited to. Then he'd lose the money.
All right. And where was he going on vacation?
Somewhere down some kind of football game, something like that, with a couple other guys. It was like a guide trip.
So just somewhere down south, that's all you knew?
It was a football, it's like a college football stadium, something like that.
Your Honor, can we just have a brief sidebar?